You have to eat the dream. You have to sleep the dream. You have to dream the dream.
What's going on, Strength Team family? Look, we're right back with another great video. If you're new to the Strength Team family, welcome to the Strength Team family. All we do over here is get gains. If you have any video suggestions or any video requests, all you gotta do is put them at the bottom, and I promise you we're gonna make that video happen. Listen, today we are focusing on our back and our biceps. For the last probably like 2 years, everybody has been asking me for a back workout that includes deadlifts, and I told y'all I don't do deadlifts. But since we are focusing on building up strength, the deadlift is one of the most superior exercises for that. So go ahead and kind of get like a guesstimate of your one rep max, because you have to use it because it's gonna be percentage based. Now, I just guessed that my max is around like 475 pounds because I literally haven't deadlifted in like 2 years. And honestly, I'm a sumo deadlifter, and the strongest I ever got, I think, was like 540. So I'm basically building my conventional deadlift from ground up. I mean, like nothing. Like my strength is just gonna be nothing. But you're gonna see it get stronger, just like I guarantee you're gonna get stronger as well. That is way too much talking. So let's jump straight into this back and bicep workout. Our first exercise, we have the conventional deadlifts. We have four total sets, and I want you to do 5 reps. Like I said, we're going to use 70% of our one rep max. So if my max is 475 pounds, I'm going to multiply that by 0.70, and that's going to give me 335 pounds. I know that's not a lot of weight, and I know it was moving extremely easy, but I am rebuilding my deadlift, so I want to start slow, and I want to be extra cautious. That way I don't throw no injuries out there right before my prep. But like I always tell you, make sure your form is in check on every single exercise, and the deadlift, make sure it is tip top perfect. Just like you're seeing in the video, my back never rounds. Like, soon as I go down, I grab the bar, I slightly pull the bar up and kind of towards me. That way I take the slack out, and then I go ahead and just think about just squeezing my glutes, and I stand up. I never hyperextend. I see a lot of people when they deadlift, they bring their back all the way back, and I cringe every time, because that's how you're going to damage your lower back. I promise you. All you got to do is just stand straight up, and that movement is finished. And with this exercise, we'll rest in between 2 to 3 minutes. And after we finish with that, we have the Pendley rows. We have 6 total sets, and we're going to do 6 reps. My weight was 185 pounds. I want the weight to be semi-challenging. I don't want the weight so heavy that you're going to turn it into a regular barbell row. Like you're seeing in the video, my back stays flat the entire time. It's a dead stop. So you're going to pick that bar up off the ground. You're going to pull it back. You're going to row it. Then you're going to let that bar go all the way back down to the ground. Every single rep, it is a dead stop. And literally, make sure you are pulling the bar all the way up with the bar touching your chest or touching right up under your chest, and then let it go all the way back to the ground. If you notice that you cannot pull that bar all the way to your body, the weight is too heavy. This exercise, we're only resting between 1 to 2 minutes because we have 6 total sets. Now, after finish with that, we have the dead stop single arm dumbbell rows. We're only going to do 2 sets, and we're only going to do 6 reps, but like I said, they are dead stop. So every single rep, I want you to let the dumbbell sit on the ground, reset. Now pick the dumbbell up, row it, squeeze your back, stretch all the way back out, put the dumbbell back on the ground, and rest another 1 to 2 seconds every single rep. Now with this, it's going to be a little bit more harder than you think, even though you're only doing 6 reps, and you're going to be a little bit more exhausted too, just because of your first 2 exercises. And I think the weight that I used was 110 pounds, but like I always say, if you're stronger than me, use more weight. If you're not as strong as me, use a weight that is challenging for you. With this, we were only resting between 1 to 2 minutes. Now, after you finish with that, we have dead stop pull-ups. We have 6 sets, and I want you to do 6 reps. Again, dead stop. Like you're seeing in the video, I want you to grab the bar like you normally do for a regular pull-up. When you pull up, make sure you are pulling your chin over the bar. And if you can, kind of hold it for a half second with your elbows down, tucking your lats in and squeezing your lats. Now come all the way back down, and I want you to hang in the hanging position for at least 1 second. That is what I mean by dead stop. You shouldn't be swinging or none of that. You should be still and stationed. And then after your 1 or 2 seconds of rest, now I want you to pull your body all the way back up as far and as high as you possibly can. Hold that position again for a half a second and repeat that. Every single set, that is what I want you to do. If this is too challenging for you, go ahead and add a resistance band. And if you're doing a resistance band, instead of you doing 6 sets for 6 reps, I want you to do 4 sets for 10 reps. Listen, you gotta start somewhere, so do not get discouraged. With this, I was only resting for 1 minute. If you need a little bit more time, that is perfectly fine. Now, our back is done, so let's go ahead and just blow up our biceps. So our one and only exercise, we have the easy curl bar preacher curls. We're gonna do 6 sets, and we're gonna do 8 reps. Now, I did not go extremely heavy. I think I had a 25-pound plate on each side, but you can see my reps are slow, my reps are controlled. And guys, and ladies out there too, I will be honest with you, by the time I got to my 4th set, I was starting to struggle on the 6th, 7th, and 8th rep. So I'm telling you, that weight is gonna catch up. You're only resting for like 60 seconds. I know it sounds easy, but you do 1 set, then 2 sets, then 3, then 4. I'm telling you, your biceps are gonna be pumped, and eventually it's gonna get challenging, and that is it. I'll see you right back here tomorrow with a killer ab day. Everybody has been asking for an ab video, and I'm gonna bring you some of the best ab workouts that you have ever experienced. But like I tell you, every single video, make sure you like this video, make sure you share this video, but at the end of the day, make sure you keep getting them gains.
You have to eat the dream. You have to sleep the dream. You have to dream the dream.